We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Vampire the Masquerade Winter's Teeth Issue 1. This is a 2020 miniseries from Vault Comics, written by Tim Seeley, drawn by Devmalya Pramanik, with a backup story called The Anarch Tales, written by Tini Howard and Blake Howard, drawn by Nathan Gooden. Both the stories were colored by Addison Duke and lettered by Andworld. Now the first story finds this enforcer who is trying to maintain the masquerade, and we get a brief overview of what that is. For those of you that aren't familiar, this is based on a role-playing game from the 90s called Vampire the Masquerade. And the masquerade is keeping up the illusion of there's no such thing as vampires. Well, we find out that this enforcer is going to have to make a choice because the Prince of the Twin Cities may be losing some power because Minneapolis is going to break from St. Paul. If this goes through, there will be another prince installed in Minneapolis and things will be drastically changed. So a lot of politics are at play, and that means a lot of changes, and it also means that this enforcer has to make rough decisions. Now, obviously, there's also the problems of mortal connections, because the enforcer also has a sister who is suffering from late-stage dementia, from the look of it, and she also makes a friend named Allie, who may or may not be a massive threat to her. We're left with a bit of a cliffhanger, and then we cut over to the Anarch Tales, which is about this group of vampire kind of outcasts that have a job in Minneapolis. The two storylines may be converging, I don't know. The Tim Seeley story, Winter's Teeth, is far superior to Anarch Tales, but Anarch Tales is okay. If it was its own book, I wouldn't buy it. It just didn't do anything for me. I thought it was kind of boring, but it might have some potential. Winter's Teeth, however, was pretty good, and if you like the role-playing game or any of the novels based on Vampire the Masquerade, you'll probably like it. And as a bonus to people that played the role-playing game, it does have the main character's stats and abilities in the back as a bonus. So you get a little role-playing supplement for like 4 pages, giving you the disciplines, skills, attributes, etc. for the RPG. So that's pretty cool. Overall, I'd recommend it. I thought the main story was pretty interesting. It's got potential. It's a little pretentious at times, but I find most of Vampire the Masquerade to be a little pretentious. That doesn't make it a bad thing. But if you're a fan of Vampire the Masquerade, you'll probably want to check it out. The art's okay. I think some of those shots really needed work, especially perspective shots where somebody's reaching forward. The hand looks gigantic and weird. But otherwise, it's okay, especially for a vault book. It's actually not bad. The art was about the same level in Anarch Tales, maybe slightly better. But I'll definitely check out issue 2. I thought it was a pretty solid book overall. And I didn't feel cheated for the cost. It does run, I believe, $5. I didn't feel ripped off for my money. I thought it was pretty interesting, so I'm going to recommend it. That's going to do it for this one. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you'd like to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.